medical side, and together we'll be able to do it. And in this case, Supreme Healthcare, if you want to go for it, the agriculture department, the health department, the education department, everything, if work together, then we can achieve Supreme Healthcare. At the same time, equitable distribution. On one side, people is demanding lots of for the vaccination. On another side, those who do not want to take vaccine, people are forced to take vaccine. So this is a classical example of inequitable distribution. By equitable distribution means those who need more, they should get it. And last but not the least, appropriate technology, for which we'll be talking about. These are the four pillars of Supreme Healthcare. Now, the appropriate technology is a technology in which should be simple one. It should be economical, accessible to all. It should be accurate and scientifically proved. It should be feasible. For example, if you are going to a village where there is no electricity, then however it may be useful, but if it is not feasible for that area, then it is not appropriate technology for that area. It should also be legal, ethical, and replicable for the large masses. So here I will be just giving you just few examples of appropriate technology, but we have listed more than 100 of such examples, which we want to develop with collaboration of all of you. Now I just will give example how we should start using this appropriate technology. First and foremost, in self-assessment. We say that this measure is useful, that measure is useful, but how people can assess their own health? Dr. Neeraj Pandit had developed very good tool of assessing self-immunity. So such this self-assessment also we can develop. History taking. Most of the time when patient goes to the doctor, they forget some of their own symptoms. So history taking also requires a little bit, whenever the person is problem, they should be able to record the data. General examination, whether it's the eye examination, ear examination, or pulse rate, BP, etc. Everywhere we can use this. As well as systematic examination. Also, for example, you want to respiratory system or cardiovascular system, all this can have appropriate technology. And then investigation, we have very clear-cut examples of various investigation which you can undo with a very simple features. We'll be talking about today hemoglobin, how to measure indirectly, and vitamin A deficiency. And we can have thousands of such investigation in future. If a treatment is concerned, there could be a various procedure by which we can make the treatment very simple. For example, people want to use eye drops. Now, when we had a large mass scale of the problem of conjunctivitis, the villages, eye drops were very costly and not accessible. With a very simple technology, we prepared eye drops on a large scale. So for treatment also, it is possible. Now, something like people say that astrology is humbug, palmistry is not useful, etc. But if you do it scientifically, then genetics and palmistry can be linked together. And in future, you can forecast the diabetes, hypertension, and so many genetic disorders, or combination of genetics and environment, such disorders can be identified if we use the artificial intelligence if in palmistry and astrology. Similarly, we should be using this technology for failure and success analysis. And based on this, we should be talking about what should be the further course. For example, in case of the COVID-19, we worked together for many, many areas, but there was no collective single data at a global level that which are the factors effective, which are the factors which are not effective. If we could have done it in a common platform, then we could have done. So I will be demonstrating how the common platform can be developed. Then we think that the various herbal medicines should be produced at village itself, rather than it is manufactured somewhere in a large stock and then taking to the people. For example, Tulsi Ark, which is very simple technology, even people can use it, that can be developed at each village, and then locally it can be used. The ultimate dream is we should have a robot doctor. which can be handled by trained health workers if you want to reach to interior areas of not only our country, but the world, so that they, at a low cost, people can be given a right kind of treatment and right kind of preventive advice. Just the People's Health and Development Trust is working for last 20 years together, health and development. And that's why we take help of a lot of the agriculture people, engineering people together for such kind of development. Healthform is a platform whereby Dr. Neeraj was also one of the time a part of it as a student, and now also as a faculty, and thousands of students have undergone the process of working in the health forum. And people can go through the mfcindia.org, and we are going to complete 25 years in June 21. And this is one of the part to ignite all of you to join this health forum. And Human Health Circle is integrating various system of healthcare, homeopathy, Unani, modern medicine, Ayurveda, and naturopathy. And we are working this direction for the last 30 years. And the M-Tech innovations, we are unfortunate in India that thousands of people have to go abroad for embedded technology for getting more knowledge that we would like to bring over here. And that embedded technology will make the thing simple of creating instruments. So now let me just give a simple example. I don't think any of the participants over here, out of 38 participants, no one has undergone probably the vitamin A level in their own body. People say there is a B12 deficiency, there is a vitamin D deficiency. Because you are detecting those deficiency, you are aware that now, yes, I need to take B12, yes, I need to take vitamin D, etc. But you might have subclinical vitamin A deficiency. How will you go about it? So that's why we have formed a very simple instrument which can be used by even the fifth standard person to detect vitamin A deficiency. And I have seen my many colleagues, the senior doctors and public, even drivers who are suffering from vitamin A deficiency. So this instrument, it took around more than 20 years to develop. But this very simple instrument, you are able to increase the light in this instrument, and you will be able to see various kind of pictures in this. And depending on the amount of the light you require to see a particular pictures, you will be able to say that you are likely to have a vitamin A deficiency or not. Now, this is without taking blood. And the cost will be much, much less, because only once you go for an instrument, then recurring cost is hardly less than 1 rupee per test. It can be taken to in the train, in the bus stand, it can be kept at RTO office, in school, colleges, etc. And vitamin A tablet is costing hardly 70 naya paisa. So less than 1 rupee, you'll be able to treat the condition. Now, second thing, let's say more than 50% women are suffering from the anemia. We know that. But where is the tool to detect their own anemic status? So we have developed a very simple instrument whereby you can find out whether you are anemic or not. In the mirror, you are supposed to see whether your tongue is pale or not. You can look like in this tongue, and then if it is pale, you should go according to the advice written over here. So this tool is basically to detect anemia, but not only detection of anemia, but it has a lot of value as far as education is concerned, as far as entry of in a particular community is concerned. So I call it as Mukta. For my mother's name, Mukta Ben, is a multi-purpose. You not have only one of anemia detection, but you have other purpose also. For example, you can find out a jaundice, you can find out the ulcers in the mouth, you can find out dental caries, so many things. So it's a multi-purpose, universally applicable, whether it's a US or India, everywhere it is applicable. is a knowledge sharing. It doesn't give only the talk about anemia, but there's a lot of write-up. It's available in more than 12 languages of common Indian languages, English, Hindi, etc., etc. So it's very easy. And treatment tracker, you are taking tablets and so many diet, etc. But every week or every month, you will not be able to find out whether hemoglobin is raised or not. While this instrument, you can daily check or you can at least weekly check whether your hemoglobin is increasing or not. And affordable oil. Why I say affordable oil? That if there is a hole in between, then you can see the tongue around 10 or 12 inches away. So if you can see the tongue in the center, this instrument is costing only 10 rupees. So 10 rupees per village can detect anemia of all 1,000 population in just 2 to 3 days. Then you will say, why people are not going for it? The reason is very simple. If you make the thing complicated, if you make it a very costly affair, then people will go for it. And my colleagues, including my teachers, everybody, not I would say everybody, most of people, those so-called scientific people, so-called doctors, so-called committee experts, they don't like to use this because they say it is non-scientific. I would not agree to them. I challenge them, prove that it is non-scientific. They don't know the concept of sensitivity and specificity. If they know the concept of sensitivity and specificity, nobody can challenge the world that this is an unscientific instrument. And more than 1.25 lakh instruments are in the market and people are using happily for the detection of anemia as well as for education purpose. So if you want to find out anemia of all the crores of the population of the world, we can do it within 1 week or so. And the instrument also gives you idea, what are the causes of anemia? What will be the problem due to anemia? How you can make your, how can you increase your hemoglobin level? And what are the foods which are giving you full of iron, vitamin C, folic acid, protein, etc. Now, there are various nutritious food available, but usually dietitian and doctors are not having much time to give you the advice that what are the constituents of wheat, what are the constituents of green leaf vegetable, etc. So this is a simple software available in multiple languages for the people to use on the desktop. And this will give you exact amount of the vitamins, minerals you are getting, what is your requirement, how much is deficient, and from where you will be able to get this vitamins, etc. Although we say that the price is 7,700 rupees, but for the community health people, for the NGO, this software is available free of cost. If you go to the website, this will give you, even if you want to prepare your own item, suppose somebody wants to Assamese item, or let's say item of the Meghalaya or the South Indian, you can prepare your own food, you can define your units and whatnot. And there is automatic printout of the food menu will also be there, depending on diabetes, blood pressure, etc. Now, let me talk about human healthcare system. There's the allopathy, Ayurveda, naturopathy, people say mixopathy. The right word is human healthcare system, integration. And why this integration is required? So we are not only human body. We have a mind, we have intellect, we have ego, we have a chitta, we have the causal body, etc., etc. And the human being is made up of lots of things. So if we keep the modern medicine in center and try to utilize the rest of the system also, I would use the word best of all, worst of none. And then if you go for this human healthcare system, probably we'll have the answer. And I'm working in this direction for last more than 30 years. I will not go into details of all this, but thousands of doctors have joined this movement. And so let's go for this principles one way ahead. Now, I want to talk about family health care. we should not talk individual healthcare in isolation. So there should be a system by which, in the same system, you should be able to record your own health parameters, doctors, lab technician, etc. If you go to the biggest hospital or more corporate hospital, each hospital is having their own software. And when patient go back home, they hardly give the details. Patient should have a right to have the knowledge about his own healthcare or health problems or the treatment given in detail. It should be there. So we are in the process of generating a system whereby everybody can use the same platform. At the same time, we are launching International Healthy Lifestyle Competition. Why International Healthy Lifestyle Competition? Because, see, one people say that toothbrush is better, other people say Datun is better. So which one is better? Where? So if we have a comparison across the globe, then it will be much better. So this software will give you the score of habit, whether your habit is healthy or not, that you will be able to judge from this. And if you want to use the demo software, you can use the demo at myhsc.in. So you can register as a family, organization, area coordinator, lab technician, doctor, medicine shop, radio. Everybody can use a single system of the patient record will be the same. Everybody can have access, provided the patient will give you access. That is very, because the power is with the patient. And in future, we want to create a situation, the doctor who doesn't want to give the data in this software, patient will not go to that doctor. That situation should be created so that there is no hidden things, the transparency will be there, and we'll come to know, the patient will be able to find out, if I have eczema, which healthcare system is much better. There should not be any infighting whether homeopathy is better or Ayurveda is better or LFS is better. Let patient decide which system is working well in that own area with their own nature, in that culture. And this is a way you will be able to add your habits, score will be there, and you will be able to compare yourself with the world. Now just one more. Any problem, Neeraj, any problem?
No, sir. There is some mic on in between. I just muted them.
Okay.
Please, sir, continue.
So, now, Ayurveda is for thousands of years. That doesn't mean it doesn't require appropriate technology, because the pollution is there. There is changes in foodstuff. So nature of the foodstuff will also change. So we need to apply the appropriate technology to Ayurveda also. For example, Nadi Yantra. Many Vaidyas can find out whether the person is having which kind of disease based on Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So if we have the instrument which is sensitive enough, and we can have a sensitive Nadi Yantra at a low cost, so that in a village also it can be applied. People can find out what is their prakriti based on Nadi and can take a preventive measure or take a treatment. I will tell you that before the parameters in the blood changes, before your cholesterol rises, before your blood sugar raises, there is some change in Nadi. And that's why for early detection and treatment, this Nadi Yantra will be very useful. Then we can have the Prakruti Nidan also with some kind of the set of questions. We have prepared 60 set of questions. If you answer those questions, you will find out which Prakruti you have. Then this is an area I have not come across any software which is comparing between the nutritive value of the food and Ayurvedic properties of the food. If I have a collaboration of all of you, then we have the database ready that if you take a wheat, according to the Ayurveda, what are the properties? According to the nutritive value, what is the nutritive value? So you might have something that if the food is having more proteins, it may be creating vayu. If it's more carbohydrate, it may create a kapha. If it's more oily, it may create a pitta. Not exactly, but we should try to correlate that it's something near to this or not. then robotic massage. So they gradually, although we say that we have a lot of manpower, but the manpower who is likely to work may not be appropriate. So this could be a simple instrument, plant identifier. Each village has not a lakhs of resources. I would say the crores of rupees resources are there in each village, but we do not know. For example, Adedo, people don't know. Or let's say Bhoyeringini, or let's say Bhoyambi, Phylanthus Niruri. We have lots of such things available in the vicinity. So if we have a plant identifier, and along with that, we know how to use it. So if you click the symptom, and you will be say that you can use these are the plants, and you can identify in surroundings, then it will be a wonderful. Now, few more examples. This is, now I'm going to a technique of how to develop the instruments, how to go for appropriate technology. Let's say question is, we want to measure vital capacity. That means you want to know breathing in, breathing out, your capacity. So simply you have an instrument whereby you can replace the water in a bottle. And you blow the water, there will be, let's say, two tubes inside the bottle. One tube above the water level, other tube dipped in the water level. So by flowing, going a flow on that, the water will be replaced. How much water is replaced, that will tell you what is your vital capacity if you prepare normogram. We had prepared this. Other thing, you want to find out the peak flow meter. Very simple. From how much distance you can move your paper, this is a simple paper. From how much distance you can blow this paper, you can move, or you have around 10 students, you want to find out which person is having more peak flow meter in a silent non-wind room. If you compare, it will be easier, and you can prepare a normogram and find out peak flow meter. And for tuberculosis patient, it can be used to measure whether it is increasing or decreasing. Vision testing, everybody knows, testing of hearing is also possible similarly. Now, let's say glucose level. So many people are having diabetes. So now almost people hardly does the urine sugar, because thinking that it is not scientific, it doesn't give the accurate things. But tears, if you measure the glucose level of the tears, it almost near to the plasma glucose level. And just like this pulse oximeter, we should try to develop all the parameters in the blood. Most of the parameters can have a sensors, and we can find out without taking drugs. And heart and lung capacity, it's very easy for people to measure. Most of the medicals are knowing in the physiology, they undergo this thing, but hardly they come out and talk to the patient that these are also possible, that you can, even the normal people can measure their heart and lung capacity on a regular basis. Then there's another technique by using the various skin has a lot of the current going on day and day out. It is said that internal organs are related with the skin. And if a particular point of the skin is having a more resistance, then the connected internal organs can have a problem. Now, this is a hypothesis. We don't know, but let's go to the hospital. Person suffering from liver, person suffering from kidney, and we find out whether this instrument is true or not. So such a simple technique, finding out the resistance of the skin particular point is very easy for the electric engineering people to measure. Then other thing is constituents of the perspiration. If it's more acidic, then it's likely that you will have a more disease. And without taking blood, the perspiration can be measured. Similarly, muscle strength, you can measure your strength of various muscles on a monthly basis and find out whether you have become weakening or you are becoming more and more strength. Very simple. You just go for the three spring from the cycle wala and find out how much spring you can displace based on it, you can find out. So it's a exercise come a measurement of muscle strength. Now, I end with this last slide, and then probably if people have a few questions, then we'll go for that, or I will present my future ideas. Now, people say that medium circumference tape is nowadays obsolete, not useful, etc., etc. But I would say that we can have color code not only for 1 to 5 years, but it could have a color code for adult also. And where weighing machine is very difficult. Even if you have, see, out of the participant which are participating, her doctors, etc., few of them may not have a weighing machine, or few of them having weighing machine but not accurate. So what we have done is from 1 month to 100 years for male and female standards are printed over here. So for at any age, as per the WHO, we can find out whether the person medium is as per the standard or not, whether it is between the standard or not. This will tell you roughly whether you are underweight or overweight. This step will hardly cost 1 or 2 rupees. So 1 or 2 rupees, 10 rupees, etc. Such a few instruments can reach to the people, but I don't think the government would like to adopt this, because this is unscientific according to them, because it is very cheap. So I think with this, instead of taking 1 hour, I just keeping the forum open for question answer. If there's no question answer, then I will just propose my 5 minutes future plan, and then we can go away. Neeraj, have koi ne kai puchhu hoy to puchhi shake chhe. Anybody can ask.
I request to all the participant who has a question, put right in the chat box, so I can read and I can convey to the sir. There are 2-3 points in the chat box, sir. They want to know that some software link, nutrition software link.
So all the link is very easy. humanhealthcircle.org. humanhealthcircle.org. Should I write over here?
Sir, in chat box you can write, sir.
Okay.
All participants are requested to write in the question in the chat box.
This is a humanhealthcircle.org is a website from which you will be able to download nutrition software and you will be able to use it.
Second, sir, in this question, there is one question regarding name of
name of the Vitain instrument is the A-meter.
This instrument is developed by sir only.
And it is M-Tech A-meter. M-Tech Innovation is a company which is started by my son, who is in USA, who was compelled to go to USA for embedded technology. I tried to prepare this instrument myself for more than 20 years. I was not successful. When my son took the place and he started doing innovation, he did it within 2 to 3 years. And now he's going to make it a final version sitting in California in USA. Just because we don't have a money, he will not be able to come back because he has to pay the loan. So this is a PT of India. We have lots of brain work, but hardly there is anybody who would be like to support the research directly. So M-Tech A-meter is the name. In future, we have listed more than 100 items for the research, such low-cost technology.
Sir, link is still not posted, sir.
Okay, now it's posted.
Yes, sir.
All products will be available on this website, humanhealthcircle.org. I've also post my phone number.
Yes, sir. Any participant, any more question?
Also, we have one of the biggest Ayurveda hospital in Ahmedabad. It's just near Sola Civil. It is in Sola Bhagwat. Niramay Tirth Ayusewa Mandir, where all the doctors of different pathies, Ayurveda, naturopathy, homeopathy, allopathy, different specialists will come to this place and then we'll find out which pathy is better for which disease or which combination is better. So we have at present with us Dr. Tulsi Bhai, who is an MBBS, is a MS ophthalmology, and last 40 years he's done a lot of work on this Ayurveda. So he's right now with us for 8 days in Ahmedabad, and he's working right now in Umeta, and anybody can meet him near Baroda. So yes, should I, any other question?
Sir, 1 minute, I will take some announcement to the participant.
Okay.
The participants, there will be link given to the chat box for the feedback. At the end of the session, kindly give the feedbacks. So you will get the certificate of this attendance also. And any question, you can ask directly to the sir also. Sir has given the email ID as well as the mobile number. And this is an important topic. I feel as a community physician, or you can say any community health worker, this area is very important, is appropriate technology. Because a lot of NGOs are working in this area, required a lot of appropriate, low cost, scientifically sound technology in the community. So we have to use this community. We are in our department, vitamin A deficiency instrument we are using, and we found in the antenatal mother, there is a vitamin A deficiency. Okay, so this is the way we have started gradual using of the such type of the instrument. I think if there is no question, sir, you can give some more. More idea about the appropriate technology, sir. Please.
For example, see those who yes, PPT will be able to share. Neeraj, I will share the PPT with you
and yes.
Send to many people. But rather, we believe to do this kind of thing. So, well, let me tell you that the. The membership is open for all people all over the world. Just buying 10,000 rupees, they'll be able to utilize our services for 20 indoor days with all facility, food and the stay and everything free, as well as they will access to a lot of things. The participant, those who are attending this, will be able to share the free nutrition software. Also, we have a scheme of giving a knowledge to the people. There's a virtual Ayurveda college, virtual medical college, virtual homeopathy college, 7 colleges are there. If you learn it for a year, the subscription is only rupees 1,000. You'll get a lot of things in that. And if you want to go into detail, then we'll be exploring the further. So go on looking at our website. In next 1 month or so, we'll be starting this virtual colleges. Let me tell you that organic food is very, very important, and the agriculture also requires a lot of technique. And that's why try to grow the plants, kitchen garden, etc. at your own place with simple technology like converting the food waste into the manure. And with this also, you will be able to develop the organic food at your own home. I think, Neeraj, I end with this with a prayer to Almighty that let's all attain the highest level of health, including spiritual health. So last few moments, if someone wants to ask, then is open.
Okay, anybody has any question? You can ask the question. You can even direct unmute yourself and ask the question. I think no question. So I think thank you, sir, for giving this informative and innovative talk this area of appropriate technology, which is really useful for the community health worker as well as the community physician and student also will learn from this. I will share the PPT to all of the participants on the WhatsApp group also, and kindly give your feedback. So with this feedback, you will get the certificate of participation also. We will post on the this feedback on WhatsApp group also. Otherwise, thank you. Thank you, sir, for participating and giving the time for this particular session. And thank you all participants.
Neeraj.